Hello friends, welcome again, and this is my new project Bookshop Management System, and I have developed this project in Java, JSP and MySQL. The version for the JDK I am using is the JDK 1.8 and the Tomcat version is 7, but if you have Tomcat version 8 or Tomcat version 9, then you can also configure and run this project on Tomcat version 7, 8 and 9. Right, for database I have used MySQL, and for connecting database with Java and JSP I have used MySQL connector, which you will get easily from the mysql.org website. Right, also this is a web application, so for front end page designing I have used HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Some of the jQuery library also have used, like for form validations and for integration or date calendar plugins, creating drop down menus, I have used jQuery plugins. Right, so let's start with the functionality go through. So the project title is Bookshop Management System, and it's a mini DBMS Java, JSP and MySQL web based project. Right, mini because it has only admin login. There is no customer login inside the system because it's a bookshop management system for the shops. Right, so let's start with the functionality go through. So this is the home page of the project, and it's a totally static page. There is nothing dynamic on this page. This is a about us page, and this is also a static page. Right, this is the admin login, from where admin will be able to log in and admin can perform certain operations. So for login inside the system, you must have the user ID and password, and for login inside the system, the user ID is admin and the password is test. This is a contact us page, and it's a static contact us page. I am not saving the value of this contact us page anywhere into the database. Even I am not sending a type of email and SMS from this page. So I am logging inside the system. So the user ID is admin and password is test. Okay, so this is the home page of the project, means that this is the dashboard of the project after the admin login. Once admin login inside the system, he will get the dashboard. So this, there are some menus here, right? So you can see, I think there is a menu link here. It's a food item site. I will change it, right? So this is a product entry from where you will be able to add the products, means say book, pencil, stationery products. You can add any number of products here, right? And after that, that product will be saved into the database, and you can use that product in the sales form, right? This is a add sales, from where you will be able to add the sales, right? Sell product, right? For selling the product, you need to enter the customer name and the mobile number, and you can add any number of products from this add more button, right? If you click on the add more button, then the number of items will be added, and this drop down will contain all of the, you can say, all of the books which is available in the database, right? You can add the quantity here, right? And the unit price of the books, like 100, 200, right, 300 and 400, and after that total quantity you need to put here, right? And the total cost will be calculated automatically here, right? You can see the total cost is getting calculated automatically, right? So after calculating it, if you want to remove some of the items, just click on the remove button and that item will be removed. And after filling all of the details, right, just hit the save sales, and it will be saved into the database, right? So once you click on the save sales, then the sales details will be saved into database, and you can print the receipt from here, right? Right, so this is the add sales report, right? So this is the report. All of the books which you added will be displayed here, right? So all of the books, you can see we have added 4 books here, and all are displaying here, right? If you want to search the books, just search from here, right? And in that you can search. This is a sales report. All of the sales which you have added will be displayed here. If you want to see the details of the sales, just click on the view details, and that sales details will be displayed, right? You can see here sales report. Right, okay, this is a logout. Once you log out from the system, then all of the session will be destroyed, and admin will not be missed. No one will be able to access the internal administration menu. So I am clicking on the logout, and this is a session driven menu, and it renders according to the user session, right? You can see the administration menu is not displaying because session has been destroyed. But if you log inside the system, the session has been set and it's showing a different menu, right? So these all functionalities I have developed inside this Spirit Bookshop management system. And as I told you earlier, this is a mini Java JSP DBMS web-based project, right? And if you need more functionality in this project, just put it into the comment. I will incorporate those changes. I will make this project more better and better according to your requirements. And don't forget to subscribe our channel for getting the latest projects videos on the latest technologies. Thanks for watching the video. Thank you very much.